Well, you've heard about the military-industrial complex, but there's a system that's pumping money into corporations while harming average Americans. Another system that some refer to as the obesity-industrial complex. And it's this system that contributes to the obesity epidemic in the U.S. So while the health and well-being of Americans suffers, who is benefiting? Well, as you'll see, big corporations are raking in the dough from the fattening of America. And not only are politicians not stopping it, it seems they're feeding the problem.
Listen, we're broke. And we need to stop the out-of-control spending spree that's going on in Washington, D.C.
As the debate over cutting government spending rages on, billions of taxpayer dollars wasted each year on junk food. Between 1995 and 2010, over $250 billion was spent on subsidizing foods that are making Americans fat.
74% of all the subsidies go to just 10% of the agribusinesses. These are not the small farms.
Public funds go to agri giants like Monsanto. The company produces genetically modified seeds and claims more than 93% of soybean and 80% of the corn market in the U.S. But this is not what Americans are consuming. The crops are turned into products like high fructose corn syrup, which end up in most processed foods. The effect on American health is devastating. 75% of Americans are now overweight. And advertisers today target kids.
The most important part of a McDonald's Happy Meal is you.
Hey, Superman, this is kryptonite for us.
The result, 1 in 5 kids in America are obese.
They like sweets, and they like all the additives that are added to fast foods and sodas and snacks.
Meanwhile, corporations are profiting from the fattening of America. They spend millions each year lobbying Congress to uphold policies that keep the big businesses profitable. David Rosen calls the system the obesity industrial complex.
That the system is essentially, it's a pay-to-play system, and if you can pay to support your local congressman or senator, you have a stronger opportunity to both not only influence the laws that are passed, but actually draft the laws.
Like Congress recently declaring pizza a vegetable.
Agribusinesses spend a lot of money lobbying on Capitol Hill and making sure that the funding is going towards things that are going to drive down the products of the most profitable products.
Also cashing in on the fattening of America, pharmaceutical companies. The U.S. spends $147 billion each year treating obesity-related illnesses. Countries from China to Hungary require labeling of GMO foods, but with the power of corporations and lobbyists to influence politics, no such laws exist in the U.S. today. In Washington, Liz Wall, RT.